Hey everyone, Techni here with the top 5 lightweight gaming mice. But I'm not going to go into a detailed spiel about all these because I did detailed reviews on every single one right there. So you can check those out. I'll leave them right down in the description for you. And all of these mice are under 70 grams and under $70. With one little exception in there. And yes, like the title says, there will be some giveaways here, but who knows which one it is. As you can see, we have all of our mice in these gorgeous stockings here. I honestly forgot which one was number 5. Son of a gun. All right, so here we go. I found mouse number 5. Now, real quick, while I'm doing these, you guys are probably just like, dude, just get to the point. You keep on talking. But no, seriously, one thing I just kind of want to cover here and bring to you guys' attention, when you watch any of these top 5 or top 10 favorite mice, headsets, whatever product it may be, keyboards or something like that, right? Remember, that's coming from the person reviewing them and the person testing them. Everyone's going to have different preferences across every single product. So I may not have a mouse in here that you really like. Again, that's not me saying it's a horrible mouse. It's just maybe a mouse that I don't prefer using. I just had to plug that in there before someone started writing some nasty stuff down in the comments or smashing that thumbs down button because I didn't have their favorite mouse in there. But all right. Enough of the politics right there, right? Let's get into mouse number 5 right here. I can't get it out of the stocking. Mouse number 5 is the Glorious Model O. Now, to be honest with you, this mouse almost did not make it to my list. If any of you have been in for a while or watched any of my other Model O videos, you know I had a hard time with this mouse, and it kind of really upset me the way the company went about the release. But if you want to hear more about that, you can go check out that video. I think I labeled it the Transparency Report or the Model O Update, something like that. So go check out that if you want to hear more. I read it straight from the company's website. But Glorious just released an update about the warranty on the Model or any of their mice, I believe. And if you have any issues with it, whether it be with the cable or the side buttons or any of that stuff, they're gonna back you up for, I believe it's 2 years. Don't hold me to that. Go read on their website and check up on it. But I think that is incredibly cool. I mean, if they're gonna back up their mouse with any issue you have like that, I mean, heck, the shape and the weight and the price is fantastic. And if you got that company standing behind and backing it up like that, complete win. But yes, some of the build quality is still iffy in my opinion right there. And the main issue is where this RGB strip is right there on both sides, because that's where the initial flex is. I mean, they've tuned it up and fixed it quite a bit because you got to press a lot harder these days. And I rarely can get the buttons to actuate, if ever. But again, when you press it in, you see it flex right where the RGB strip is. So I think if they took that RGB strip out right there, made it a solid piece, I think we'd have an incredibly solid product. Heck, you might even be able to reduce some weight. Come on, Glorious, take that RGB strip out here. So all in all, as far as the Glorious Model O right here, it's a fantastic buy and a great value. Is it the best lightweight mouse? No, not at all. But I really like how they're standing behind and backing up their product. And at 50 bucks, again, it's just a great value. All right, so mouse number 4 right here. Let's see what we, oh wow, this is one of the giveaway one, guys. Mouse number 4. All right, so let's see which one we have here. Let's open this bad boy up. I'm excited. You guys excited to see which one we have right here? Again, this is one of the giveaway ones. Oh, very nice. Nice. The G-Wolf Skull. But all right, let's see what color we're gonna be giving away right here. Now the Skull Mice, they come in a variety of colors right there. I believe they range right around 70 bucks and they come in at 66 grams. Which color do we have to give away here? I'm trying to build up the anticipation. Oh, son of a gun, you can already see it. Well, there that goes, right? Anyways, the Skull Mouse we will be giving away is this green one here. Check that out. It fades from the black up to the green. Oh, this thing is gorgeous. Maybe I should just keep this. Now, as far as the G-Wolves mice right here, I mean, these things are incredibly solid. I mean, number one, you have your outside packaging with this hard cardboard. Then it comes in this collector's tin right here. Really cool. Now, I've gotten a few and they've had some different tins on them, so I'm not too sure which tin you get with your mouse. But anyways, you do always get a tin right there. Of course, you get your mouse inside there. They give you an extra paracord, some extra buttons right here, and then in here you have some extra feet, some side grips, the sticker right there and everything. Coming in at 70 bucks, number one, you get a fantastic mouse. The package is just great, right? But of course the package is not gonna do anything for a mouse, right? But as far as all the replacement stuff you have, if something ever goes wrong with it, bam, you can pretty much just repair it right there and you're good to go. But the main thing, I mean, the shape of this mouse is fantastic. If you like that ergonomic shape, you're really into that palm grip, this thing is fantastic, and it's only coming in at 66 grams with that nice RGB right around the bottom right there. And you, again, you have so many color variations. I mean, just look how gorgeous that is. Nice little subtle RGB right down there. Kind of radiates down onto your mouse pad or your table. And again, it just feels fantastic in the hand. Now, one thing some of you might be asking, with the Skoll when they first released, there was a lot of creaking and a little bit of side flex right on the side. Not much by any means, never actuated the buttons or anything, but right down here by that RGB strip right up here, it would move around a little bit, kind of just like the RGB strip on the Model O right there. But again, never actuating the buttons, but my old one I used to have, I had a gray one, and it would really creak quite a bit when you'd press right there. But they have fixed that. Actually, when you look down here, the camera's not gonna be able to pick it up because it's so minor, but if you look right down here where that creaking was, you can see a little clip. So you can tell the bottom is clipping into that top right there. And there is no flex, no creaking whatsoever on the Skoll mouse right here. So very nice to see that they did fix that. Now, I'm making this thing sound so fantastic, which again, it is. I absolutely love this mouse. I love it so much. But the reason I gotta put it down here at number four is I cannot stand the honeycomb on the side. I wish they would have made the side all solid right over here and then on the other side. Now, yes, they do give you the grips within the package right there, but it just felt weird for me. Because again, when you put them on the side, then I have that little lip sitting over there, and I just felt that brushing up on my hand, that's just me being nitpicky, right? I love that smooth transition going throughout the entire mouse. And when I put the grips on the side, it kind of bothered me a little bit. Now, again, this is all me, just personal preference, because whenever I game, especially a lot of Call of Duty or Fortnite I've been playing, I get in an intense situation, I'm gripping the bananas out of my mouse right here, you know what I mean? So again, after a long play session, my thumb starts hurting, or my side pinky over here starts hurting because it's pressing into that honeycomb. So if G-Wolves could make this with a complete solid side right there, still keep it lightweight and everything, wow, 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 this mouse would never leave my desk. All right, so lightweight mouse number three right here, what do we have? Which one do we have? This one's tight. This one's really tight here. Oh geez, I'm probably gonna get some slack for this one, putting this at number three. I'm gonna get some slack here. This is the Razer Viper. But all right, so the Razer Viper, and why I said I'm probably gonna catch a lot of slack for this, because I know a lot of people have the Razer Viper as number one on their list. And yes, it is a fantastic mouse. I love it. Most people have the Ultimate up there, but I honestly think the Ultimate is pretty stinking expensive. And this is the one exception I had with this video. I know I said 70 grams and 70 bucks. The Viper does come in at $79. But again, I think the Viper coming in at $79 is still a good buy. When you get into the Ultimate, what is that thing, like 140 or 150, something like that? I'm sorry, that is expensive for a mouse. But as far as the wired version of the Viper here, the cable is fantastic, one of the best. It shoots up a little bit so you don't get all that drag right there. The shape and the build of this mouse is great. Rubber texture grips on the outside, very nice matte coating, doesn't attract too many fingerprints right there, nice recessed scroll wheel, finger grooves, no holes. We just have that very nice, sleek, stealthy look right here. This guy comes in at only 69 grams. So Techni, why the heck do you have this thing at number three if it's so fantastic? And the reason for that, at least for me, are the side buttons. I cannot stand the side buttons one bit. I mean, they're way too flush with the mouse right here. I gotta get up in there and actually press into it and feel, I just gotta go out of my way too much to press the side buttons. If they bring them out just a pinch, this mouse would easily be number one, but they're not. So for me, I have boxed up my Viper and it's been collecting dust, and it really stinks because I love this mouse. All right, so mouse number two right here. Let me tell you what, that Viper is just a really heartbreaker, because again, I love that mouse, but those side buttons, let me know down in the comments if you used a Viper, or if you've ever felt it before putting it in your hands, what do you think about the side buttons? Again, like I stated in the beginning, these are gonna be completely different for everybody, you know what I mean? Heck, my number five might be your number one, and as far as the shape and feel, you know what I mean? But let's go on and get into mouse number two right here. Golly, this one's tight. Oh yes, the XtraFi M4. All right, so the XtraFi M4. If any of you, again, have watched my review on the M4 right here, you all know I absolutely love this mouse. The other great thing about the mouse right here is the company. They stand behind their products. You just go on their website. This isn't me just, you know, blowing smoke or whatever. You go on their website and you can read it right there. They don't believe in just spitting out these products, right? They believe in quality first, right? Before they produce all these products. And again, they made a solid one here. Now, what makes the XtraFi M4 so fantastic? Number one, besides the company being great, the build quality. and the shape of this thing is fantastic. It's got that ergonomic shape right here, but it's not a really big ergonomic. You can bring it up to that claw, use it as a fingertip if you desire too, but again, you can bring it into that very cozy palm grip, and the shape doesn't really feel like anything else. It has its own shape right here. It feels fantastic in the hand. Some of the great features on the XTRFY M4 right here. Number one, the cable is incredibly lightweight. Straight out of the box, it can feel a little bit tight right there, but give it a week or two, break that cable in, and you're gonna be prime stinking time. Again, the shape is fantastic. The really cool thing about this mouse, you don't need any software whatsoever. Adjust your DPI right on it right here, adjust your RGB right on the mouse. And the RGB is just crisp and subtle right there. You have the scroll wheel right around there over by your side buttons and everything. And it's really cool. If you look through the holes right there, you can see the XTRFY logo. But unfortunately, why I had to put it at number two here, just kind of like the skull over there, is the holes on the side of the mouse right here. As you can see, the holes on this mouse are just circles and they're a little bit smaller. You don't have that traditional honeycomb cutout right there. So again, with my tight grip, yeah, I do feel it, but it's not as bad as that honeycomb cutout. My thumb doesn't really sink into it too bad. Now again, just like that skull, XTRFY, if you can make one of these with that side solid right there, I don't care, increase it a couple grams, you know what I mean? Wow. This thing would be absolutely hands down perfect. Also make one in red if you don't mind. But again, as far as the XTRFY M4, I can't praise this mouse enough. Definitely one of my favorite mice right here. I love it. It has such a unique shape to it and it feels fantastic. I highly recommend everybody to try out the XTRFY M4. All right, so our lightweight mouse number one right here. You know what I said? Giveaways, right? And I've only done one so far, so this one must be a giveaway, huh? It sure enough is. Yes. Again, two viewers from the Techni. All right, so lightweight mouse number one. Under 70 grams and under 70 bucks. What do we have? Another G-Wolves mouse, the G-Wolves Hatte. All right, so as far as the G-Wolves Hatte right here, I mean, this mouse is fantastic. Again, coming in a variety of colors, just like the skull right there. Now, I just checked on my phone of the price coming this guy, because I remember them being at $69 for pretty much any color, but now as far as the colors, they're ranging from about 74 up to 80 right there. I don't know if we're trying to get some holiday markup right here, but again, I remember these guys being at 69 bucks. As far as the color we're gonna be giving away is also that, I don't know, what do we call it? An aqua green or something like that? But you get that fantastic packaging again, that really solid cardboard box out here. You get this tin right over here, and then you get some extra feet and then the sticker and everything in there, extra mouse buttons and an extra paracord. Now talking to Hatte right here, this thing is fantastic. You can bring it back and get that palm grip, claw, fingertip, whatever you want, and they all feel fantastic. Very pronounced clicks right there. I mean, it looks awesome. And as you see, we have these solid sides right here. This is exactly what we need to do with the skull. What I would compare this to is the G Pro Wireless. Almost a spitting image actually of the G Pro Wireless. Now, if you want to know more about the G Pro Wireless, again, make sure you subscribe and hit that bell right there, because I will have a review coming up very soon on that one as well. Everything about it is fantastic. I mean, it looks gorgeous too. That's just a bonus. You know what I mean? I think even at, let's say 80 bucks, I still think it's worth it. Again, getting that extra paracord, getting those extra switches and everything, and anything ever goes wrong with it, bam, you can replace it and kind of tune it back up right there and be back up and running. But hey, please do let me know down in the comment what your number one lightweight mouse is. Not, oh, hey, this one and this one. You got to pick number one. Again, my number one is the G-Wolves Hatte right here. So please let me know down in the comments what your number one lightweight mouse is. So how to enter the giveaway. Number one, you have to be a subscriber, right? Number two, all you're going to do, again, is just leave right down in the comments what your number one favorite mouse is. Now, hey, if you want to spread the word, go off and share this video on Twitter or just share the YouTube video anywhere, I would highly appreciate the extra love for sure. Now, the giveaway will end on January 17th. I know it's a Christmas video, I'm releasing it on Christmas here. Would have been awesome to be able to ship this out on Christmas, right? But anyways, it's gonna end on January 17th. Just give everybody a fair amount of time to enter up here. Now, yes, unfortunately, it does have to be US shipping only, but if you are overseas, you can still enter up. And if you're willing to pay the shipping, please do enter up. I now have a donation tab that's gonna be down in the bottom of my videos right there, or right up in the about tab or anything. So if you're willing to pay for that shipping, we'll talk about it right there, get the actual price up, and you can still enter. Again, if you're willing to pay that overseas shipping, trust me, it's usually pretty stinking expensive. But all right, everyone, so that's my top five gaming mouse right there. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you're having a very happy Merry Christmas, spending it with your family, friends, and just opening some awesome presents, and good luck with the giveaway here. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, hit that thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe for some future tech videos. Hey, I hope I catch you in the next one. Bye now.